6 points to nominate a rider for the Joker. Russia 31, Denmark 30, Poland 26, USA 20. If Poland drop a further point behind the leaders, then you could be looking at Janowski or indeed Golub going for double points in the last two, in one of the last two heats.
Well, it's certainly a surprise here because the Poles are having a really tough time, and basically they've been a three-man team tonight because Valasek has really struggled to get amongst the points. He's had an awful night, and it's a massive surprise certainly to his team manager because he came into this meeting in really good form and just hasn't been able to find the setup tonight to get amongst it. Protasevich has also been relatively disappointing, but you've got to say he needs to come up with something special now. But what a meeting. This really has gently built through the night. The track conditions have been difficult for really tough and really exciting racing, but heat 17 there was really super stuff. We've got the moisture back in the track, there's a little bit more grip out there, and the pressure's really on. Three races to go,
and we remind you, only the group winners tonight, the winners of this meeting, go through to the World Cup final against Sweden, and the next two second and third place teams tonight go into the race-off.
And the significance of that is the fact that there's only one place available in the race-off.
It's the hardest race-off ever.
Absolutely, and it quite often is the hardest race meeting we see all season long. So winning tonight is vital.
Heat number 18. Piotr Protasevich off the inside in blue for Poland. Gate 2 yellow, Leon Madsen for Denmark. Billy Hamill, gate 3 white for the USA. And Roman Pavazhny off the outside in red for Russia. What a meeting this has turned out to be. Promises to be an eventful conclusion, no doubt about that, in Big Gosh.
Slight delay here, Nigel. I think the tapes just may have broken, or part of them there. Marek Šízlak, I'm telling you what, he's enjoyed so much success over recent seasons. His team have just literally roller coastered through the World Cup. Yeah, tapes just snapped there, so there'll be just a momentary, a small pause. But Marek Šízlak's been used to so much success over recent seasons. Got to remember that the Poles have won the World Cup 5 times, have won the last 3 years in succession, first team to win outside their own country. And tonight, in a depleted squad, all sorts of injuries. Jarek Hampel, of course, there with his leg up. Got to say that Koloce had found his form and had broke his hand, and he's out of it as well. And with a disappointing return of points for Valasek, it's been a really tough night for him.
Christoph Kasperzak, I'll give that name to you.
Yeah.
Worth consideration.
Definitely. Definitely. He's been in decent form himself, and I'm sure after the performance of Valasek, they're pretty ruthless in Poland. I'm sure he'll be in.
Kasperzak set to return to the Elite League with the Poole Pirates after the World Cup. This is heat number 18. It's nervous. It's tense. Who will emerge here in a vital heat number 18?
Madsen.
What a start from Madsen in yellow. Sensational start. And here comes Hamill up the inside in white. But there is Protasevich for Poland. Piotr Protasevich hits the lead. Can he hang on to that lead now as Leon Madsen is going to pressurise him? Roman Pavazhny is the man in red for Russia, who comes through into second place right now. As things stand, Poland will move on to 29 points if Protasevich holds this lead. Second place for Pavazhny would put them on to 33, and Denmark would be on 31. So this would still do Russia nicely, Kelvin.
Yeah, this is doing them good. Leon Madsen there just seemed to be riding the wrong line. He's gone out wide and gone backwards. Protasevich went up the inside, looks comfortable out in front. Got to say that Pavazhny's having a better ride there in second place, staying out of trouble. He's been involved in all sorts of shenanigans tonight, but Protasevich coming good in his last ride. This is really warming up. Are the Poles going to have a last minute fight back here?
Oh, whoa! How close was that between Pavazhny and Madsen? We're in the last lap, and every lap counts here in this very tense World Cup event. One, the win is for Pepe Protasevich. What a win it is. And Roman Pavazhny, second place for Russia there. He was all over the place towards the end of the race.
Yeah.
But he managed to hang on. And that is a big result in the context of the meeting, because still, Russia will be happy with that result from Roman Pavazhny. And I would suggest it gives them an absolutely wonderful opportunity with two heats to go to win this meeting.
Best race of the night from Pavazhny. Been disappointing so far, but the captain comes good in his last ride. A really good sterling performance under pressure from Leon Madsen. But Protasevich just giving the Poles a bit of a squeak here with two races to go.
Protasevich the winner with Roman Povasny second. Leon Madsen was third for the Danes. And Billy Hamill at the back for the USA. His World Cup is over. But it's been good to see Billy back in Europe. And here's what it means with two races to go. Russia 33, Denmark 31, Poland 29, USA 20. They won't qualify now, we know that.
No.
So who is going to win this meeting? Russia looking good. And now Poland need Mats Janowski and Tomasz Golub to win the last two races.
Yeah, and then hope results go their way. Otherwise, they're not going to go through to the final at the end of next week. Brilliant start from Leon Madsen. You've got to say he charged to the first corner, but I just sense he just rode the wrong line here. Protasevich gets to the front coming out of the first corner, sweet as you like, up the inside. And there's a really good race-long battle. Leon Madsen, this is late on in the race there. Povasny had passed him earlier and made him work very hard. And Madsen finally switches back to the inside and puts the Russian under pressure. Protasevich rides the best race so far, his last ride. Ride five, he finally picks up a three-pointer. And they're 4 points back, so it's still a big call for the Poles to win tonight. In the sense that they very well will be in the race up on Thursday, but the Russians are doing a sterling job. But two races to go, two vital races.
And a reminder, on Monday night, we're at the Norfolk Arena, Kings Lynn, as Team Great Britain go into action with Scott Nichols, Chris Harris, Danny King and Ty Woffenden.
Yeah,
they'll be up against Australia, including Jason Crump, Chris Holder, waiting on Darcy Ward, 50-50 at the moment.
Yeah.
Davey Watt in the Australian side. Czech Republic and Germany there as well. That's going to be a top night on Monday
night.
Yeah,
it will be. It was last year. And I'll tell you what, the Norfolk Arena puts on a great show. But it's warming up nicely. The World Cup underway now. Never fails. Great week of Speedway.
Gregory Laguta off the inside, Mats Janowski off two for Poland, Niels Christian Iversen off three for Denmark, Ricky Wells off the outside. Remember a couple of years ago when the event one was in Gorzów and Poland absolutely hit a record score, and it wasn't really that entertaining to watch, to be honest. But this, the fact that it's been so close and so tense tonight, has made it very, very interesting, and well, we still don't know who's going to win the meeting.
Well, the Russians still enjoying themselves. They're looking confident. Povasny's putting his faith in Sifuna, and I'm just turning to him. Don't worry, mate. We're all relying on you. And certainly Laguta's played his part. Bit of a problem with the Povasny. He's always got a smile on his face. But he deservedly so. You know, the Russians have, they were fancied coming into tonight. And they've done a great job. The Poles have been below their best, no question about that. They've sort of got a B team out here tonight. Problems with the tape, so another delay. But the B team tonight, the surprise is Nigel Valasek. You know, Valasek's had one of them nights. He can be a little bit like this in and out. You know, he seemed to jump off the bike almost earlier on, or the front wheel washed out. Don't really know what caused him to come off, but he really hasn't done himself justice, that's for sure.
Well, it's going down to the wire to decide who goes through. Of course, Russia could wrap it up here.
Yeah.
They could technically qualify, although Poland haven't used the joker, of course.
Well, maybe a joker in the last race might just get them out of jail, but that really would be quite special. Golub could do that sort of thing, but you do think that at this stage with a four-point lead over Poland, Russia, was it 2 points over Denmark? Denmark really are the main threat, and you've got to say with Niels Christian Iversen coming up here, he's been in pretty good form.
Yes, Denmark could do with Iversen delivering the goods here. The Russian is Skrigor and Laguta in red. This is team number 19, the penultimate race of the night.
Well, Laguta's
made a beauty off the inside gate. Second place is Janowski coming through. It's Ricky Wells in white for the USA, and at the back now is Niels Christian Iversen. This could be a dream result for the Russians here now, because the lead is with Grigory Laguta. This would put them up to 36 points.
Oh.
Poland would be on 31, and it would mean that Denmark would be on 31 as well. Technically, with a joker, Denmark could still do it as Iversen comes through now. But Grigory Laguta going about it the right way to put Russia through to the final here.
Yeah, Laguta doing good out in front, but Janowski's looking for a way through. He's going right out wide here, going to make a big long straight there and try and turn back up the inside. Oh! And he does, but only because Laguta makes a massive mistake and goes to the back. Nigel, this throws it wide open with 1.5 races to go.
Drama in the extreme.
Whoa.
In Bydgoszcz. Janowski has taken the lead. Iversen is second. Laguta is third. third. This will put Poland on 32. This will put Russia on 34. Denmark on 33. We are going to heat 20 to decide who wins the meeting and who goes through to the World Cup final.
Well, you couldn't script it. Out in front, going great guns. Laguta looked like he was going to wrap it up for the Russians. Just switches off momentarily. Klaus defends down the back straight. Janowski and the other two lads come charging through. Laguta's out the back. The Poles pick up a win. Three on the spin for Janowski. They're right back in it. What a World Cup. It's come alive in the last three races.
What a dramatic conclusion. Russia could have been virtually home and try. Janowski wins it. Iversen second, Laguta was third. Wells at the back. And look at the progressive totals with one race to go. Only the winners go to the final. Look at that. Wow. Russia 34, Denmark 33, Poland 32, USA 20. We know the USA are going home. Who will win the meeting?
You still fancy Russia with Saifudinov coming out in heat 20. Unbeaten so far tonight, but will Golov do something spectacular? We could see a runoff for the victory, yet if Saifudinov finishes third and Golov wins out in front. Here we see it. Laguta off the inside. Excellent start away. Looks really comfortable. Plenty of speed out in front. And then late on, decides to do something inexplicable. Loses concentration, clouds the safe defence, and all out of shape. Here we see it. Bosh! Oh, lifted, out of shape. All out of control. Janowski comes stealing through and he relegates himself to the back, and that's why we've got this last heat decider.
Well, in the next race, here's an example for you. Greg Hancock wins it, heat number 20. Russia finished last, Poland finished second, and Denmark get a third. We will have three nations on 34
three-way
points.
Three-way runoff. So all sorts of permutations here. Pressure on, drama. Looked like Russia was sailing through, and then suddenly Laguta there just got too much grip, clouded defence. Janowski was ready to pounce. What a night he's had, by the way. Disappointing in his opening ride, but has then stormed back with three excellent victories and has looked really world class. But going into heat 20, 2 points between the top three teams, fantastic.
Well, we remind you that if it is a tie at the top, there will be a runoff, a one race runoff to decide who wins the meeting and who goes to the final. So, as it stands at the moment, Russia lead by a point over Denmark, 2 points ahead of Poland. It's 34 to Russia, 33 to Denmark, 32 to Poland, USA on 20. But Greg Hancock is the USA representative here. If he was to win, and Thomas Golub was to finish second, Michael Jepsen Jensen third, and Emil Saifudinov at the back, we would have a three-way tie between Russia, Poland and Denmark for top spot.
Well, it's interesting now seeing the lineup here. Hancock on the inside, Saifudinov in gate two. Golub is in gate three. Gate three, no question, that's the hardest place to win from. Got to say the inside gates are going to be an advantage here, no doubt. Plenty of pressure on. People looking on concerned. Jepsen Jensen's had a great night on the outside. 2 points between the top three teams. What way is it going to go? Will Golub now come up with a masterclass in heat 20?
Well, there's been a bit of criticism about the new format, only being 20 races instead of 25, but it's proved to be an absolutely thrilling contest, this, in the end. Now, the racing hasn't been as spectacular as we have seen Big Gosh before.
No.
But it's been a close contest. Hancock off the inside. Emil Saifudinov for Russia, who lead on 34. Thomas Golub, gate three, for the third place Poles on 32. And Michael Jepsen Jensen, who is off the outside gate for second place Denmark on 33 points.
Yeah, Jepsen Jensen's had a good night too. He hasn't been frightened at this stage at all. These youngsters coming in, the Danish team, and really giving it his all. But Saifudinov, he's the form man. He's unbeaten so far. Can he wrap it up for the Russians now?
Remember, the race-off for the first time. Only the winners of the race-off go to the final. The race-off is one to miss, that's for sure. Heat number 20, the stakes are high. A place in the World Cup final is on the line, and Saifudinov wins the start. Hancock has it, but Saifudinov's coming up the inside for Russia now. Emil Saifudinov has lost it.
Yes,
coming up,
yes,
Jensen Jensen for Denmark.
No.
Hancock is second. Saifudinov third. Golub still in the mix as well.
Oh, Golub's in the front. From nowhere, Golub comes from last to first.
Saifuddinov
hits the front. Three abreast going down the back straight. Saifuddinov there hits the front. Gonov up the inside, shoves him wide. Hancock's around the inside, he's in front now. Oh my goodness gracious me. Saifuddinov and Jepsen Jensen crash. What a two laps of speedway that is.
Here comes Mr. G! Thomas Gollop has the lead! Greg Hancock second, Saifuddinov is third! Hancock has the lead again! Going into the last lap, Hancock the leader! Thomas Gollop second, third is Saifuddinov! Saifuddinov on the back wheel of Gollop! Gollop's going to try one more time! Hancock's got the lead! Here comes Saifuddinov on the inside! Russia are looking good! Hancock
wins it all! Jepsen Jensen nearly steals third place off of Saifuddinov, but Russia, it looks like they've done enough! Looks like they're going to the final. What a speedway race that was! The World Cup, we say it year after year, never fails. But that was a masterclass, and that was proper speedway.
1 point for Emil Saifuddinov is enough for Russia. Sensational speedway in heat number 20. Just as I was saying, it wasn't the most spectacular we've seen, because that is one of the best races you will see in the world anywhere this year.
Fabulous speedway in E20. Greg Hancock showing him why the reasons why he is the world champion and why he is leading this year's world championship. Terrific ride for him, but what a speedway race. Too much action, actually, to really get your head round there at times. Saifuddinov and Golov having a fantastic meeting, a fantastic ride in E20. But I tell you what, the Russians have done remarkably well tonight, and they fully deserve to go through. But E20, I'm still getting over it. I'm going to have a lie down while you say the result, please.
Greg Hancock the winner, Thomas Gollop second, Emil Saifuddinov third, Michael Jepsen Jensen at the back. Remember, there was a collision in that race as well. And this is the final score. Russia 35, Poland 34, Denmark 33, USA 23. Russia qualify for the World Cup final in Manila, Sweden next Saturday. And it means that Poland and Denmark must go to the race-off.
And the race-off already is shaping up to be something very special indeed. Next Thursday, don't miss it. But I tell you what, this was a privilege to watch this and commentate on. It was an excellent start initially from Hancock. He's out in front, but then everything goes. This is a roller coaster for a Jepsen Jensen. Makes a great fist of things initially up the inside. Then later on in the race, Jepsen Jensen then clouts the side of Saifuddinov. Golov gets himself to the front, but then rides too wide, and Hancock, the old master, gets back up the inside and steals the win away from Golov. Look for a moment that it was going to go the Poles' way, because Poland would hit the front, and with the American Hancock in second place and potentially Jepsen Jensen coming through, all the permutations with one lap to go was still well and truly on. Fabulous speedway. The World Cup's here. The Russians are through.
Have to pay tribute to Greg Hancock and the USA. Valuable, valuable addition to the World Cup this year. Hancock, magnificent. And we really didn't give him credit there, because the race was so spectacular.
It was such a classy performance. Yeah. He was the spoiler in the race, and it could have gone the way for the Poles there for a moment when Golub got his nose in front. But Saifuddinov has been brilliant tonight. And the consistency of the Russians, they haven't carried anybody tonight. Everybody's chipped in. Pavezhny in the last race. Artem Laguta, that's his partner there, and the baby on board. Had a disappointing season in the Grand Prix last year, but he's delighted to be in the World Cup final.
Congratulations, Russia. What a story. What a meeting in this Monster Energy Speedway World Cup has provided us with a great meeting. Niels Christian Iversen is the Denmark skipper. What a night they've had.
Niels Christian Iversen, what a meeting. I mean, 2 points at the end, not quite there.
No, it's so close. But again, you know, we didn't manage to win it, you know, and we were halfway through, you know, we really, really believed that we could go all the way. But, you know, fair play to the other teams, you know, they're strong, and we have to go race off now.
You mentioned the race off, that's going to be a special meeting as well.
Yeah, it's going to be really tense. But I think, you know, it's hard. It's only one place in the final, and we're going for it.
Very young side, a great performance tonight.
Yeah, I think it was good racing, you know, all the way through our team. You know, they did really well, and, you know, I think we can be proud.
No one's listening, but Nicky Pedersen's holiday going to be cut short now?
Sorry?
Is Nicky's holiday going to be cut short now?
I think we're going to call him, get him out of the pool.
All right, thanks, Niels. Well done.
Yes.
Well, so get out of the pool, Nicky Pedersen. Get your...
Tell you what, it's going to be difficult to drop any of them.
Absolutely.
They've all done really well tonight. Whoever gets left out, if they get left out, they'll feel disappointed.
Well, second place tonight, of course, went to Poland. And as the host country tonight in Bydgoszcz, Tomasz Golub is going to have a chat with Steve Brandon right now.
Tomasz Golub, so close, but yet so far.
This sport, my team is in the last 1 point, yeah? It's not more, maybe. Next meeting in the Manila in the challenge, and I think it's to win in the big final race.
You mentioned that you're going to go Thursday and look at that. It's going to be a very tough meeting.
Very hard meeting in Thursday in Manila. I think it's I know what changed the bike the my team. I think it's concentration in the next meeting in the good race.
You've been very well supported by the Polish fans tonight. Have a few words in Polish to them.
Dziękuję Polakom za kibicowanie. Byliście fantastyczni. Trzymajcie za nas kciuki w Malii. Myślę, że damy radę. Wiem, że jesteśmy osłabieni troszeczkę w takim składzie, ale zrobimy wszystko, żeby grać w tym wielkim finale. Dziękuję wam bardzo.
Dziękuję, Tomasz.
So, the race off, as Kelvin mentioned already, is shaping up nicely with Poland and Denmark. And remember, only the winners of the race off will go through to the final. We know Sweden, we know Russia are in the World Cup final, and Emil Seyfudinov, the winner for Russia tonight, with that third place in the last heat.
Emil Seyfudinov, there's only one word that comes to mind: wow.
Yoo-hoo! Yeah, I say before meeting, you know, is but you know, is final, so will be us, and we do that, and we have, you know, is now is. A little bit holiday and going to Malila, getting some medals. I think it will be gold.
I mean, amazing performance tonight from the whole team. Everyone contributed good points.
You know, it's this meeting, as you must know, is each rider take points and will be a success. It's like it's today.
I know you're very excited, but a few words in Russian, please.
Yeah. Привет всем российским болельщикам, спасибо за поддержку. Мы старались, выиграли, и сейчас поедем в финале бороться за золотые медали. Спасибо вам. До встречи. Целую, мама.
Thanks.
Well done, Emil Seyfudinov and the Russian boys. And let's just confirm then the final scores tonight on a tough night of Speedway. Russia 35, Poland 34, Denmark 33, 2 points between the top three nations. So we now know that the race off on Thursday night in Melilla will feature Poland and Denmark, and the second and third place team from King's Lynn on Monday, Great Britain, Australia, Czech Republic and Germany. What a night that promises to be. 7:30 Monday night, Norfolk Arena, King's Lynn, and it's live on Sky Sports. The final is next Saturday in Melilla, Sweden as the host nation seeded direct, and Russia, tonight's winners, are into the final. What a mouth-watering prospect the week ahead.
Indeed.
Is. It started in style tonight in Bydgoszcz, and I'm sure the rest of the week is going to be pretty special.
Yeah, it always is. Brilliant finale there. What a grandstand finish that was. It was superb. Heat 20, you've got to say. The Poles will be disappointed, of course. They are the reigning champions, and they've been dominant in this competition in the last 3 years. And now they go to that race-off, and only the winners going through. So really no guarantees that the Poles will make it to the final. Very competitive meeting coming up next Thursday. And the Russians have been great, you know. A lot of people talking about their prospects tonight, positively about their prospects this evening. And they really showed great consistency. They were led brilliantly by the young Seyfudinov. He knows the place well. Rides here, of course, in the Polish league. But admirably supported by the Laguta brothers and the captain, Poważny, at 35, coming up with those 2 points in his last ride. I think that was so important. They came up with strong performances when it really mattered at the back end of the meeting.
Absolutely. They have other riders as well that coming through the system. Denis Gizatulin that we see at Eastbourne in the Elite League, of course. But it is a great story. And the Russian League, well, it does have a reputation of paying riders big money to ride in Russia.
But I know Jason Crump, the three-time world champion, he's now riding out there. They have to travel vast distances. You know, Russia, you forget how big that place is. But you've got to say, since the emergence of Saifudinov, who burst on the scene a couple of years ago, the Russians have now qualified direct through to two World Cup finals. And I don't think that you can rule them out. They could potentially pick up a medal next Saturday.
Well, on this type of form, and we know Saifudinov likes the Melilla track. It's the type of track that,
yeah,
well, it's a proper speedway track.
Well, so's Bidgos. It's been a bit slick tonight, and it finally made some grip there at the end, and we saw some super racing. Too slick in the beginning. Can understand why, because the weather's been so difficult in the last day or two, but Bidgos, we've seen some sensational stuff we did there in Heat 20. But Melilla, without question, Nigel, you're right. That is also a sensational speedway track. As is the Norfolk Arena on Monday. All good tracks this week. We're going to see some great racing.
Yeah, that heat number 20 tonight was sensational.
Oh, it's going to be hard to beat this week. No question about it. It's, you know, they've set the bar high, haven't they?
Very much so. So we're going to see the Russians celebrate their victory tonight with a tremendous performance, and just that third place for Saifudinov was enough.
Yeah, it was a tough race, but I think that's one of the best performances I've seen from Saifudinov this year. He's been okay in the Grand Prix. He's been making lots of semi-finals, but has failed to make the finals, hasn't made the big start when he needed it. Monster Energy, of course, here supporting the season. It's their World Cup, effectively. They are really pushing the sport hard, but you've got to say the Russians fully deserved to be on the top step of the restroom tonight.
Well, we now respect the Russian national anthem.
Well, we don't hear it often, so we might as well hear the full version of the Russian national anthem then. And a remarkable feat for Team Russia coming through there. Emil Saifudinov really did lead from the front. His 6 points as a joker in Heat 16 no doubt put them in a good position. with me, Sam Olenko, Chris Lewy. A good performance from Russia.
Yeah, Emil is an inspiration to that team. You know what he's done in the Grand Prix as a young lad, and he's led from the front, as you said, and they fully deserve. I expected them to be strong today, but I didn't expect them to go straight to the final, I've got to admit.
Poland and Denmark go to the race off. Only one team of the four are going to the final to join Sweden and Russia in the World Cup final on Saturday, Sam. Tough day on Thursday.
Yeah, you would want to avoid that as much as possible, and Russia's done a good job to do that. But we know Denmark's has got a little bit more in depth if they need to get some backup on there, but it's going to come down to Poland's got to deal with what they got. It's going to be hard for them.
What about Melilla as a track very quickly?
Much, much different than this racetrack. You really do need to have your setups right, and you can't really slide into position and bump somebody out of the way there. It's a hard track, and it does produce good racing when you got good riders on.
So as Russia enjoy the adulation of the fans, they've saved themselves that Thursday, of course, to go. And that's it for today, for Event 1. But we're back on Monday as Team Great Britain aim to go direct to the Cup final like the Russians. We're at King's Lynn for Event 2, and that's live at 7 p.m. on Sky Sports 2 HD for those of you that can't make it to the track. The race-off is the last chance for just one more team to make the Cup final. Join us live from Melilla in Sweden on Sky Sports 2 HD for the penultimate clash. And on Saturday, it's the Speedway World Cup final as the three teams that have fought for the right to meet seeded Team Sweden do battle for the Ovi Funding Trophy and the title of World Cup champions. Such a lot to look forward to, but that's it from us for now. From Chris, Sam and myself, thanks for watching. See you Monday.